you to come down.
They did not train you at your house. You are a coward.
Me.
I'll show you, Pepe. I'll show you the stuff I have.
I have told you not to try me again, foolish woman.
I have told you not to try me again, stupid man.
I've never seen a very stubborn and useless man like you. I've never seen you. You argue with your husband.
Hey.
I told you about to argue with me.
Hey.
I am your husband.
Do you know what
I have right over you, Mr.
Useless husband. See, you're telling me that you have rights. Mr. Man, let me tell you something. We have equal rights in this house.
Equal
and whatever I say stands.
We have equal rights in this house?
Yes.
Is that what you're telling me?
Yes.
Is that what you're telling me?
Yes.
In your Bible. In your Bible.
Oh.
You have not stumbled at woman. Respect your husband.
Oh, story for the gods.
Miss.
So you are telling me that you are reading the Bible. Have you forgotten Ephesians chapter 5 verse 28?
Yes.
That says, husband, love your wife as you
am
love
am I not
your
loving
wife.
You?
Hey.
What is the evidence? What is the proof? If not, that I vow and I promise God that I will never lay my hands on you.
Oh.
I don't have time for you.
Oh.
Rubbish woman.
That's it, that's
stupid woman.
You
I will kill you.
Like
I will kill you.
In this
house, I will kill you. You're
a coward. You're a coward. Never am I even going to. Nonsense. I get
I was reading the scripture yesterday and something caught my attention. I was reading from the book of Ephesians chapter 5.
Oh,
let me read it.
Ephesians chapter 5?
Yes, Ephesians chapter 5. I think verse 22 and 28 to be precise.
Okay.
It says, wives, submit yourself unto your own husband as unto the Lord. And verse 28 as well. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself.
Mm.
I have been ruminating over this passage of the scripture since yesterday. What the scripture is saying, I know that there is more to it about submission, so I want you to shed more light on it.
Okay. I know you are very conversant with the scripture, but according to what I saw here, is that what the Bible is really telling us is this, that the more a husband loves his wife, the more the submission will be getting, and the more a wife submits to his wife, the more the man continues to love him, the more the expressions of love. So it takes the two to do the job. Maybe I get it. So
yes.
There's a need for the wife to love, to submit, and there's a need for the husband to also love. So the more you submit, the more I love you. The more I love you, the more you are willing to submit to my authority. Hope you get my point.
Yes, sir. Yes.
But one thing we need today is the grace of God. We really need the grace of God to fulfill this mandate. Hope you are getting it.
Yes,
I think this is what I see in the scripture.
Grace of God. So, my husband, we need to pray more and ask God for the grace to live in peace and to love ourselves.
That's true. We need the grace of God. And I don't pray that we have 1 hour quarrel in this marriage.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I want us to beg the Lord for our life. Please pray to God.
God must help us.
There is a need for us to call on God.
Jesus.
Can we pray to the Lord that you will give us grace? Give me grace to know my wife. And give you God grace to submit in the mighty name of Jesus. I receive grace to love my wife with all my heart. With all my heart. In the mighty name of Jesus. I receive grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Make sure you take your
deals. Okay. It's only me in the house now. I don't want you to go.
Yeah, I also miss you, but I have no choice than to go.
Yes,
you know, I have a lot of things to do over there.
Good morning, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, my
Hope
friend.
Hope you're fine.
I'm fine.
How's your husband?
He's fine.
Well, let me leave the two of you.
All right.
I'll miss you.
Take care. Safe journey.
You. All right, take care.
My friend.
How are you doing? I miss you.
I missed you.
Let's go inside.
So much. It's been a while.
Mrs. Josie. Welcome.
It's been a while. I'm very happy to see you, Mrs. Johnson. I've missed you too. Look at you.
Abi.
You're looking so good and getting fatter and fatter every day. Your husband is really taking care of you.
He's trying.
I don't even need to ask if you're fine. You are fine. You're actually from your head to toe, you're fine.
He's trying his best. Hope you are fine as well.
Am I fine? I'm fine, Sha. I'm fine.
Your reply is so much. How is your husband? How is everyone?
Hey, you just mentioned the thorns in my flesh.
Thorns? Thorns are so your husband.
Ma, I am not enjoying my marriage.
What is really the matter?
I regretted the day I said yes, I do to you.
To that extent,
he just changed. You just begin to behave irrationally in a way that I don't even understand. And you know, I'm a gentle girl. Oh, I'm so calm. I don't like trouble. But he will shall do something that will shall make me to raise my voice in the house.
What can cause that?
I don't know. And I prayed before I said yes, I do. I just regretted everything. That man is just, he's just something else.
This is a serious matter.
It's a serious, that's why, see, if I take any drastic actions, that's why I came here.
My sister, calm down. This thing is very, I don't even know what to say, because I think Brother James is a very good brother, and he's a believer. So what's the matter? What happened?
Now that was then, see? What I have in mind is either divorce or separation. Well, separation is not a sin now.
Ha!
It's not a sin.
My sister! Separation!
I can't cope. I'm tired.
Hey!
Don't you look at you now. Look at you. You're enjoying. Look at my neck. See my neck.
Hey!
Look at me.
This issue is very serious.
It's a serious one. No? I just need your advice. What do you want me to do? Or else, I'll do what is in my mind though. Because I can't bear it again.
I think at this point, the advice I'm going to give you is that you should go back to her mentor. You know, before we get married, she led us to know the will of God for our life. And at this point, we need to seek her advice, because there are confirmations before you said yes to him. And all this that is happening, I don't understand.
I don't understand too.
See, I think that's the solution. If you are going to listen to me, let's go back to our mentor and seek her advice.
No problem. If that's what you want, that I should go.
I think
it's better we go and she says something, or else I'll do what is in my mind though.
No, it's not up to that, my sister.
Okay.
All will be well. God is going to solve this problem.
I'm tired of the marriage, hey, my dear sister.
My sister, you have to be strong. You have to be strong. God is going to solve this matter. I believe in God.
Amen.
There's nothing he cannot do. My sister, please, let me find something for you to eat.
Find something for me to eat, Ken. He will soon come back from work and he start opening his eyes that he's hungry. I'm hungry. Let me be going.
So, mommy, that's just, I'm tired. I'm tired, ma. I'm tired of my marriage.
Sister Joy. I don't know why you're tired. But you prayed.
Yes, ma'am.
I can even remember that time I told you to go back and receive a word from God. You came back and you told me God spoke.
Yes, ma'am.
And you heard.
Yes, ma'am.
So now, what is not the problem? What is causing problem in this marriage that you can't cope with by his grace?
I don't understand too,
it
ma.
It truly is spoke and heard.
I don't understand too, ma. I don't.
What is the problem you can't cope with in this marriage? You don't understand.
I can't explain it, ma.
Sister Joy.
Lord Jesus, I want to hear your voice concerning my marital life. I don't want to miss it maritally.
I don't want to marry the wrong man, Lord Jesus. I want you to speak. Do not be silent. I want to hear your voice concerning my marital life. Ah, Jesus, I must not miss it maritally. I must not marry the wrong man. I must marry the man after your own heart. Lord Jesus, settle me maritally. Oh, Jesus, settle me maritally. In the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, settle me maritally. Settle me maritally, Father. I don't want to miss it. I am your child. I don't want to miss it maritally. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, have mercy. Hey, Jesus, have mercy. I don't want to marry the wrong man. Have mercy. Reveal unto me that right guy. Reveal unto me that right brother. I want to see him. I want to receive his name. Oh, I don't want to miss it maritally. I don't want to make the wrong choice. I want to make the man after your own heart. In the name of Jesus.
My daughter, peace be unto you. Stephen Adewale is my will for you. I am the God of Israel. Peace be unto you.
Jesus, have mercy. Oh, have mercy. Hey, Jesus, have mercy. Oh, give me that right name. Oh, in the name of Jesus, I want to receive the right man for my life. In the name of Jesus, I want to receive the right brother. In the name of Jesus, I don't want to miss it maritally. Let's do that. I don't want to miss it maritally. In the name of Jesus.
Why are you disturbing yourself? You already have what you are looking for at the tip of your finger. You already have affection from this corner, Wale. You love each other. You know each other. That won't be a problem. It's my will for you. Peace be unto you.
In the name, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Just thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, for in Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. Wow. God is faithful. God is faithful. I heard it. I received that name. I received that bro, James Kolawole. Wow. Thank you, Jesus. I'll forever serve you, Jesus. Ah, you are faithful. You never leave me at any point in time. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Ah, I'm relieved. Ah, I'm relieved. I'm relieved.
Sister Jo.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you now see? Can you now see where you virtually missed things up? You thought you heard the voice of what? Of the Holy Spirit? Why? It was the deceiver who was busy deceiving you. Just because of affection.
The importance of discernment cannot be overemphasized when it comes to issue of life as a Christian. It is not only in marriage, it is not only when you are searching for life partners, but as a Christian, the spirit of discernment is something we need to desire from God. So that when the deceiver comes, we're able to recognize the voice of our Father. We know it's our Father that is speaking to us. Sister Joy, I don't know, maybe you still remember this Bible passage. The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 14.
And no wonder, for even Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. Devil, he can disguise at any point. You had two voices, but you couldn't recognize the voice of your Father. The spirit of the discernment is important. But at this point, both divorce and separation is not an option. If you still remember the Council of Bloodport or the book of Corinthians, in the book of 1 Corinthians, that should be chapter 7, verse 13. If any woman has a husband who is an unbeliever and he consents to live with her, she should not divorce him. You know, see, both divorce and separation is not an option for us as Christians. The only thing you can do at this junction is to pray. Because the foundation, looking closely to the foundation, what can we say to it? Is God involved? Sister Jo.
Yes, ma'am.
So, the only thing you can do at this point is to pray.
So this is the cross I have to carry.
Prayer is the only solution. Can we just pray together? Can you say, Lord, I receive grace. Lord Jesus, I receive grace in time like this, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.